Good morning, teachers and students, and welcome to a brand new edition of Mass News. My name's Mia Rodriguez.
And I'm Ellie Alemán. Plenty of interesting things are happening right here in our school, and we're here to cover them. Let's take a look.
On today's episode, Mass Means More shows us how different magnet strands benefit from having more than one teacher in the classroom.
Feature team will be providing you a few solutions on how to deal with the stress of club meetings overlapping.
Then we take a look at Justin Bieber's comeback by releasing his new single, Yummy.
Expanding school with so much to offer. With a wide variety of magnets, all with their own criteria, having multiple magnet teachers can be beneficial to the school's success.
But it wasn't always like this. Originally, magnet strands only had one magnet teacher, oftentimes making it very difficult to manage. However, things have changed, and now each strand has multiple magnet teachers. We now go on to Maria Borges with this story.
Since 2017, Miami Arts Studio has been a full magnet middle and high school. All of our magnet teachers are dedicated in ensuring that each and every one of their students can learn to their fullest potential. But how does having more than one magnet teacher benefit the class as a whole? Hi, I'm Maria Borges, and you're watching Mass Means More.
One of the many magnets that benefit from having multiple magnet teachers is our very own broadcasting program. Having multiple teachers can make an exciting dynamic and make the teachers' jobs a little easier while making the students' days a little brighter.
What I love about it is that we kind of haven't delegated a leader to the program. The three of us lead different components of the program. Whereas before, when you're alone, you're kind of having to tackle or juggle all of those elements as one person.
From a student perspective, having multiple magnet teachers can be very beneficial to learning more about the career as a whole. Instead of learning from one skilled professional with one point of view, they now have multiple.
Having different teachers gives you different types of points of views and different levels of criticisms. You know, one teacher looks at one thing and then another one looks at another thing. So you get the whole view of like what type of performer you are.
The kids are getting like a multi-directional perspective of theater from all of these different areas. And then if they want to delve into the different worlds of it within the theater, they can come to any one of us.
Building on that, it's kind of having also, we all share the same skill sets, but we're all four very different people. It also allows the students to have a chance to pick mentors within the group of people in our department.
As you can see, having more than one teacher in a magnet classroom can be highly beneficial for the student and even make learning a little easier. Now that each magnet has multiple teachers, our students can truly get the full experience of what each subject has to offer. This has been Maria Borges, signing off.
Ellie, you look exhausted.
Mia, exhausted is an understatement. I've had two Honor Society meetings, one club meeting. I don't know how I'm gonna get through all of this.
Thankfully, our Mass Feature team has some helpful solutions on managing your stress in clubs. Here's Isabelle Greiner with the story.
Throughout a student's high school years, it is important to consider how being involved in extracurriculars can help with college applications. However, with a busy schedule, it can be difficult to balance these school activities with academics and magnet work. Luckily, we have a few solutions that'll help keep you from being overwhelmed. Hi, I'm Isabelle Greiner, reporting for Mass News.
According to a survey conducted by our Mass News team, 56% of participants are in four or more clubs. Here are two common issues with clubs and how you can try to solve them.
Don't sweat it if you're struggling with overlapping activities, such as meetings and rehearsals. Communicate with your club sponsors and teachers to find a way to attend part of each commitment. You could try going to the first half of one meeting and the second half of another.
All right, so students here at Mass especially like to be very involved, which is a wonderful thing. However, it can be a setback for them as well as for the club sponsors when they're constantly needing to miss. I created like a meeting calendar of all the days for the year. And in doing so, the students know well in advance when they have a meeting, whether it's for SGA or sophomore board, when their meetings are, and they can plan accordingly on how that may or may not conflict with another club.
Another issue faced by many is finding time in a busy schedule to do homework. Try putting all pending assignments in a planner at the beginning of the week so you know exactly what to expect.
A plan club is basically a club about time management and making it fun. We tend to say things to ourselves and then we say, oh yeah, I'll remember that. And then a week passes and we don't actually remember that. So as much as like we don't want to do it, we do really need to write stuff down.
As the year progresses, make sure to keep these tips in mind to avoid any stressful situations. Once again, for Mass News, I'm Isabelle Greiner, signing off.
Girl, you got that yummy, yummy.
Mia, what are you listening to?
It's Justin Bieber's new song. It's called Yummy.
Justin Bieber's back? I'm fangirling so hard right now.
That's not all. You have to see what's in store for the believers in 2020. Here's Mass Entertainment's Amanda Andesani with the story.
I love this song.
Oh my god, I feel like I know this song.
That's a new song by Justin Bieber. Oh, yummy.
That's right. Justin Bieber started off this year by making a comeback with his first new solo in years called Yummy.
The 25-year-old pop star's long-awaited solo single is pop-infused R&B track. The single appears to pay tribute to his wife, Hailey Baldwin, with lyrics such as, I'm elated that you are my lady. This single was released on Friday, January 3rd, and was a hit throughout the media.
Bieber began teasing his new single late last month and counted down to the release with a series of posts on social media. He also showed his fans a short teaser before the release, displaying someone eating a slice of cake off a plate with a photo of Bieber as a child and the title of the track.
Within only a day of releasing Yummy, he surprised the media with the new music video for his song on YouTube and revealed his upcoming YouTube docuseries. Justin Bieber also joined TikTok. He currently has 2.9 million followers with three videos dancing and miming to his new single, while encouraging fans to do the same. This song certainly generated a lot of hype within a few days. We went to see what the media had to say about his new song release by doing an Instagram poll on our Mass News Instagram.
The results are in, and the majority of students surveyed surprisingly thought Justin's new song was a flop instead of a bop. But while most thought his song was a flop, the majority of students were excited that Justin was making a comeback. Also, his song did in fact rank at number 1 on the Hot R&B Songs and Hot Country Songs, which makes him the first artist in history to do so.
After 4 years of not making a single, there is no doubt that this song was a huge hit. Most would agree it was definitely worth the wait.
All we can do now is wait and see what else Justin Bieber plans to do this year. I'm Dasani Beasley.
And I'm Amina Felipe. Thanks for watching Mass Entertainment.
Before we end today's show, let's take a quick look at the weather forecast for this weekend. On Saturday, there will be a high of 76 degrees and a low of 68 degrees with a 10% chance of rain. On Sunday, there will be a high of 80 degrees and a low of 66 degrees with a 0% chance of rain. And finally, on Martin Luther King Jr. Day, there will be scattered thunderstorms with a high of 77 degrees and a low of 52 degrees. Make sure to be prepared for any incoming weather this weekend.
Thank you all so much for watching another episode of Mass News. We appreciate the support that you guys give us each and every single week.
Make sure to drop a comment, like, and subscribe for more weekly videos. I'm Mia Rodriguez.
And I'm Elia Aleman.
Signing out.
Don't forget to follow our Mass Instagram, YouTube channel, and Twitter.
Hey everybody, thank you for watching this week's episode of Mass News High School Edition. But the fun's not over yet. Make sure to tune in every Monday morning to IGTV at Mass News HS for the episodes of the Mass Lineup. I'm Mira Rodriguez, signing out.